for Mark Roberts. I think that Mark was the first Renaissance man that I met. He was an artist, a photographer, a musician, a traveler. He loved Vespas. He loved Polaroid cameras. He loved selling art out of a van on Lake Street. And what I remember most about Mark was his friends, his generosity, his big, big heart, and his willingness to share anything with everyone. He was a true, true, amazing person.
The J. Hunt Gallery is the only gallery in the Twin Cities that deals exclusively in the medium of photography.
It's wonderful. It's marvelous. You should care for me.
The photography is the youngest of the arts. The technology was developed in the middle of the 19th century and has only recently achieved wide acceptance as a legitimate art form. The beginning collector faces many bewildering questions, and although the situation demands a great deal of investigation, a good way to begin is by visiting a gallery that specializes in photo images.
You've got a nice start. You've got a beautiful start for a collection. But I don't think you should necessarily lock yourself into just Sutcliffe's or just vintage prints. I think what's got to be the mandate is what you like. I think you should buy what you like. I think the people that buy out of a gallery, a lot of them aren't really too concerned with investment potential. There was really a love affair with that image. Then pretty soon you see them more often. Suddenly they're over that initial shock of paying more than $10, $15, or $20 for a photograph. That's a shock a lot of people have to get over. Suddenly they recognize it as an art form, but when it comes to putting the money out for it, that's the real test. And it's amazing, you know, they'll buy one print and then suddenly they start a collection. They become very discerning. They start reading more about photography, they start looking at more exhibits, and sometimes they'll isolate one photographer and collect his work. Sometimes but they live with them. Very few people stick them in a vault, they live with them.
My favorite thing about Mark is he'd always call me kiddo. And I feel kind of old to be called kiddo, but he always made it. I felt really good when he did that. Made my day. He knew it.
I have a lot of fond memories of spending time with you, Mark, but I think probably one of my favorites is it was a series of experiences where I would witness you selling the hot apricot brandied sundae to clients at Muffaletta as the king, of course. And hearing your embellishments and your sense of creativity in making up the most ridiculous stories about this thing really speaks to your character as a person in general. But just hearing you talking about the sundae, making up countries where it's illegal and other just random falsities was just so delightful. And I remember witnessing it the first time and then seeing you do it over and over and over again and just thinking, what a marvelous creature this is.
My favorite Mark Roberts recollection is, I can't remember the name of the hurricane, but everyone in Florida was leaving, trying to get away from the hurricane, and Mark said he was the only one on the plane going to Florida, and the reason was he wanted to windsurf. I believe he pulled his shoulder windsurfing in a hurricane, but he did. Mark Roberts windsurfed in a hurricane. That's the Mark Roberts I know.
I would say, as far as servers go, Mark's food and wine knowledge was not spectacular, but when it came to making the guest feel special or making sure the guest had a good time, he was unparalleled. Now, Parasole, who owned Muffaletta, used to hire a company that would send out what we called secret shoppers, where they would come in and dine secretly and would critique the restaurant. They would fill out a form that critiqued everything from the food to the service to how clean the bathrooms were, etc. After one couple had been waited on by Mark, their form came back to Muffaletta and they couldn't praise Mark high enough. They said he was so great that they would be happy to sit on the floor to be waited on by Mark again. And you know what? I feel the same way. We probably all do. We would be happy to sit on the floor just to be waited on by Mark again one more time.
Hello, this is Siva. I stayed at Mark's place. I was staying in the basement when I initially moved to Minneapolis like 4 years back. He was a really nice person, and he did he showed me like places around.
If there is one story, this would be the one I would tell. It's not a particularly PC one, but we were working one night at the restaurant on the line. We were just getting killed. We were just so busy, and all of us were very frustrated. And Mark came up to the line, and he looked at all of us, and he just said, "Did I ever tell you about the first time I got the clap in Tijuana?" And then he walked away. And all of us were so shocked, and it just burst into laughter. And he never did finish the story, but that was the ability that Mark has. He could always make somebody smile and make their day better.
He was just an amazing art photographer, artist. Loved talking about classical music with him. We'd go to the Minnesota Orchestra together. But a great impact on my life. Learned so much from him about art and music.
During his job interview, he was just so amazing. And I just thought to myself, for Muffaletta, wow, this guy has so much amazing experience and he could not be more qualified. I'm wondering why he's going to be, you know, wanting to work for us. And I'm so glad in the end that he did. We all just had such, he just drew everyone together in such an amazing way.
Hi, my name is Daniel Gamillion, and I knew Mark through his artwork and his passion in life was always very clear in that, in his, you know, how he saw his vision of the world and what he wanted to create and leave to it. And it was a pleasure knowing him and working with him. And he'll be missed.
I knew my way around computers better than he did, so he would routinely give me calls out of the blue, just looking for help resizing an image or something in Photoshop, and I'd try walking him through it on the phone, and it would just frustrate him and confuse him more, so I would always end up going over to his studio, within a day or two, and give him a hand with that. And every time I would talk to him on the phone about it, at the end of the call, he'd say, "Oh, okay, great. Bring coffee." Because that's probably all he really wanted was coffee.
But one of the biggest things for me was always his laugh. It could just completely light up a room, and it was very, very infectious. As far as stories go, I'd say the first day I met him was a pretty memorable one, as it probably was for most people. But I was his, he was basically training me to be a server at Muffaletta. And I don't know why, it was probably planned, maybe not, but he had a sheriff's badge with him. And he gave it to me and he told me to put it on my uniform because we were going to have a group of women who were from the police auxiliary's wives or something like that. I can't remember what he said, but something along those lines. He's like, "Yeah, you put that sheriff's badge on, they're going to love you." Well, it was a busy day and we were running around, and I get to the end of the day, I look down and I'm still wearing this sheriff's badge. And it kind of dawned on me that those women weren't from that at all. And I asked Mark about it and he goes, "Yeah, no, absolutely not. I just wanted you to wear around a sheriff's badge all day while you worked." So that was a pretty memorable introduction.
He'd be the last one on a lot of times, and he'd come get my keys from me and move my car out to the front of the restaurant so I wouldn't have to be walking out back where it could be dangerous to my car. And so he did that
just pretty much every shift that we worked together and he was closing.
When I joined the Vine Arts, I had my videos, my artwork ready to go, but unfortunately the projector was broken. So I had a portfolio of some of my art, unframed, simple stuff, stuff back to childhood, and I handed it around. When everybody was going to vote, Mark stood up and said, "I'm not standing for this. This is unprofessional. This is ridiculous. You should be ashamed of yourself. This is just wrong." And he started stomping away. Then he came back and said, "You can't do this to people. You need to be professional. I can't believe you did this," and stomped away. I wouldn't vote you in. And he left. Later, he found out that I was improvising based on the fact that the projector had my presentation didn't work. And he apologized. He was very gracious about it. I said, "Mark, I love you for telling the truth. You were right, even though it was not my intent." Anyway, we became friends. I loved him, and he became a great mentor. And I imagine his booming laughter is bringing joy to the heavens.
Mark taught me about kind of the psychology of serving in some amazing ways. He could just take control of a table and really guide them through an experience. He could talk back to his customers. He could surprise them. And it was really a remarkable talent that he had in relating to people and his experience. And it was wonderful to be a recipient of that.
There's nobody like Mark who could make you laugh. You would laugh so hard with Mark. He was the most charismatic person I'd ever met. My sister fell in love with him instantly, and she's probably 35 years his junior. It was just his blue eyes and his charisma and his sense of humor. One of my favorite memories of, there's so many memories of Mark, but one of my favorite memories is I told Denise and Mark a story about how me and my coworker had found the three wise men, those 6-foot plastic light up Christmas decorations. They were really garish. We found them in the trash when we were at a work site, threw them in the back of the station wagon, and then plugged them in at my sister's house overnight. And she was really mad, and I knew she would be. So the following winter, I found 2 plastic light up 5-foot penguins, one on either side of my gate. It was probably 4 feet of snow at that time, and I immediately knew who had done it. And I never retaliated, but it was very funny. Mark is very missed, and there was nobody like him. I'm sure everybody agrees.
I hope it's fitting. I'm sitting at a baby grand piano to talk about Mark Roberts. The first thing I thought of was that if it weren't for Mark, I would not even know what a theremin is. And every time I hear a theremin, I think of Mark. So that's a fond memory for me, even though it seems kind of silly and simple. And how he would treat my kids when they would come into the restaurant with me at Muffaletta. Always get them a soda or ice cream. They could always count on a special treat when Mark was around. So. Those are 2 of my fondest memories of Mark, who was just a really great person.
One thing we shared was a flair for a non-conventional wardrobe. We both like to get up, dressed up and catch people's eye and look a little ridiculous. We both had great fur coats. He, of course, had his great goat coat, and I had a rabbit coat that I found at Goodwill. It was always great to hang out with Mark and make it a night, and those are memories that I'll never forget.
Hello, my name is Richard Bonk, and I wanted to take a moment to express my gratitude for Mark, for his support of the artist community, especially quality fine artists, and his support of myself. And for all his contributions, his inspiration, his encouragement, his open-minded connection. And also wanted to thank him for this plant. It's a begonia. He gave us just a single leaf cutting a few years ago, made us promise to encourage it to thrive. Now we have two huge begonias. So if anyone out there would like a cutting from Mark's plant, which was actually gifted to him by a woman before she passed decades ago. So we're keeping this plant, the clones of this plant, alive. Anybody would like to remember Mark through this plant, let me know. Thanks so much, Mark, and everyone who's supporting Mark.
When I first moved into the Ivy Building for the Arts, I noticed there was a sign up on the wall that said, anybody interested in forming a nonprofit art gallery, come to this meeting. So I go to the meeting. There's about 20, 30 people, mostly young MCAD grads that had a strong presence in the building at the time. And you had Mark Roberts as well. He was probably the elder in the room. You could really tell, like, he had already been through a lot of what we were talking about and had already lived that experience. And he was so gracious in, like, how he shared and so patient with how he let us figure things out on our own while at the same time guiding us. And really helped us to figure out what it was we wanted to do. Eventually, we ended up creating the Vine Arts Center, and that came out of that first meeting. Mark was on the board with me for a while, and I remember one time, like, you know, he ducks out of the meeting early, which, if you know Mark, that's, like, not unusual. So, like, he takes off. Now go back to my studio when I'm all done, and I'm walking down. I go, what the hell is in front of my door? And I see this, like, little black shape. And I walk up, and it's a penguin, penguin about this big. So then I'm like, who the hell put that there? I don't know. Next day, I come downstairs, two penguins, one on either side of the door. Next day, I come down, three penguins in front of my door. Next day, four penguins. I'm, like, trying to figure out who else was, like, putting penguins in front of my door. Another day, fifth penguin comes, and I'm just like, okay, this is getting hilarious, right? Whoever did this, like, has resolved to see it all the way through. So I find out that it's Mark. The next day, he comes to take his other four penguins and leaves me with the one that I have. I still have that penguin right outside my door. And I'll never leave it. Mark.
He was kind to me and my artwork and my family. And funny as hell. Supportive as hell. I miss you, Mark.
Just wanted to say we love you, Mark. Miss you, and you were just the kindest, most intelligent person, and you really left a mark on the world. Thank you.
As far as a favorite Mark story, it's really hard to narrow them down, but I would have to say one of the most memorable is when we were working at Muffaletta. When I was on vacation, Mark actually brought in this ugly hobo painting on velvet that we purchased together on one of our thrift shop runs. And he told Jessica, the server, that I was working on a new series of velvet paintings, and I really wanted her to have it. And of course, she was horrified. It was awful. And she didn't know what to say to me when I returned. And so when I did return, she approached me and just said, you know, I got that velvet painting of the hobo. And I quickly said, oh my God, Mark gifted you this horrible painting. And if you know anything about Mark, he loved gifting things to people. I mean, things like this, you know, like the hobo painting, but everyone has got, like, some kind of trashy or weird Mark gift. And that was the case at Muffaletta. Everyone had a gift. And so Jessica wanted to get Mark back. And I think a lot of us were in on that joke. So what we did is we took all these gifts and modified them. Basically, we made our mark on them. And one day we brought all the gifts wrapped to Muffaletta and surprised him with it. And he was genuinely shocked and also impressed with our variations of these gifts. And so I want to share with you what I did with the velvet painting that I made. I have to say that I did not go into velvet painting. That's the one that I've made here is probably the only in the series, but I would have to say it is the best. And it is of the king, appropriately.
He was adventurous. I mean, yeah, we always thought of him as a photographer, but at a certain point, I don't even think he carried a camera anymore. He was always making art and photography with other things, whether it be Carillium or chemiograms or even SX-70 photography. I mean, he was willing to experiment, and I loved his enthusiasm for taking a chance.
Is that so sexy?
We're going to miss him, but do you know what he really liked? If you showed up at his gallery wearing a good Hawaiian shirt, he was really enthusiastic. What do you remember, Amy?
I've actually known Mark most of my life. I remember seeing him at Muffaletta, but most of the time we would just go to his studio and hang out. And I always remember he was just so enthusiastic and always loved to show us what he was working on or in the middle of or putting together.
I don't know. For me, what I found so interesting in this box is how two artists can work from two different directions with two different concepts and come up with what they're both incredibly happy with.
And just always so fun and full of life and...
Love you, Mark.
I love you. I hope you're on the most radical cosmic journey ever. And I'm sending you so much love from California.
And I know he's creating wonderful art in heaven. And I miss you, buddy. Okay. Take care. Thank you.
Mark is probably off windsurfing in another dimension, and I'm wishing you a good tailwind, buddy.
I saw Scotty Dog, and I just thought this is the time to shoot this video, and I love you, Mark.
So yeah, he definitely changed my life and was a very important part of the time that I was at Muffaletta.
And I'll miss him. I'm grateful that I knew him, and every time I hear Mr. Bojangles, I'll think of Mark.
I think trying to limit myself to 1 minute of what I'd like to say regarding Mark is too tough of an assignment. There's no way anyone who's ever met him would ever be able to distill Mark down into 1 minute of a tribute.
I miss you, Mark. I love you so much, and your stories will live on as well as your art in our memories and in our hearts.
Love you, Mark. I miss you, and I'm glad we get a chance to remember such an amazing guy.
You know, once upon a time, when I started out in photography many years ago, a dark room was just that. It was this mysterious place where you would go in, you'd work in the dark, quiet, wonderful place to work. But now...
I'm gonna need Dektal 1:1.
Now I have my friends come over, put Vaseline on their face.
Over all of my face.
Yeah.
You're getting a hairdo and you get to make
a facial.
We take photographic paper, we press it into their face, in full room light, and zap. All we have to do is process it, and we have a print. I needed some images of people that were burning in hell, that were tormented.
Did I explain to you what the image is? It's called Cries from Hell. Are you going to be happy in hell? No.
Well, it depends. All my friends will be there. But all the things you tried to hide
will be revealed on the other side. In order to make this particular piece authentic, I felt it was necessary to take those people I knew that obviously are going to burn in hell, I mean, there's really no question there, and utilize them as my models. And
And when I saw what was coming out of the darkroom that particular day, perfect. Exactly what I was looking for. Tormented souls. What I really enjoy, the real fun part, and I think the creative part, is getting my friends to put Vaseline on their face and rubbing paper up against it.